Hello everyone, I'm Stefan Chandler Garcia, a developer evangelist here at Salesforce. In my last quick take, we talked about how we can use data attributes to extend the HTML elements within our Lightning Web components, and then capture those attributes within that JavaScript file of the component. If you haven't had a chance to check out that video, you can find the link in the description below. Because today, we're going to be talking about expanding upon those data attributes and dynamically styling our components based on the values that we've then added. So the first thing we're going to talk about is how we can use CSS selectors that target those data attributes. And then secondly, we're going to talk about querying the data attributes that are associated to elements within our HTML template within our Lightning Web component, and then modifying the styles from there. So let's go ahead and get started. Looking at where we left off on the last video, we have our list of contacts here on the left, and as we select a contact, we can capture that data-ID of the element and then add it to the selected contact lists, just like we did in the last video. Now, as I mentioned, the first thing we're going to do today is use that data attribute as a CSS selector so that we can apply a style to that component or to that specific tile that we want to highlight. In this case, each of our contacts has a custom field called level, and that level has a couple of different field values. And in this case, we're going to be looking for that value of primary so that we can highlight those primary contacts within our contact list. Now to do that, we're going to first need to go into VS Code and add a data attribute for that level so that we can merge in the contact's value. And we're going to call that data-level and then add in contact.level __C. And now that we've done that, if we pop over to our CSS, we can go ahead and I've already written two selectors, but we're going to go ahead and modify one of those. We're going to go ahead and take that red selector, and we're going to remove the selector that I've already written, and we're going to replace that with square brackets. We're then going to add in our data attribute there, so data-level, and then we're going to add in the value that we would like to add, and in this case, it's primary. We can then go back into our component and refresh the page as it loads. And there you go. You can see that it's now highlighted those primary contacts based on that data attribute. And it's a really good and cool and easy way to style our components dynamically if we know that those values are going to be exist or modified as that data changes. Because as those data attributes update and change, the style will obviously change on the component. Now, you'll notice that when we click on one of the contacts, the style doesn't apply to the selected contacts list, and that's because we're not applying that same data attribute to our list item in that side of the component. We're only applying it to our current contact list that we have on the left-hand side. Now, let's talk about our second usage of data attributes, and that's by querying the template for those specific elements and then modifying those classes associated to those elements. Now, looking at our component as it stands, when I select a contact multiple times, we then get duplicates in the list. So we're not doing any dupe checking there in that array. We're just sort of adding them into the array as they come and go. And so let's go ahead and take a look at how we can do this. Let's enhance it by first checking that the contact has already been added to the list. And then if it has, let's query for that element that we've added the data attribute to and highlight it for the user to see that it's already been selected. And so we're going to do that by first popping into VS Code. And we're going to scroll down to that list item that we have not modified yet, that selected contact list item, and we're going to add a data attribute of data-selected ID, just so that we can differentiate from that contact, that data ID that we're referencing in the first list of current contacts. And we'll go ahead and merge in the contact ID there. And then let's go ahead and pop over to our JavaScript. So in our JavaScript file here, we're going to go down to that handleClick method where we're capturing the event. And then we're going to add a constant for storing selected contacts. Now in there, to get those selected contacts, we're just going to go this.selectedContactRecords.filter, because we want to find that contact within the selected list. Specify a single property and then match that on contact.id and then check that that's equal to the contact ID that we're setting in the constant above this. Next, we're going to write an if statement around that selected contacts to see if any were found. That way, if a contact was found, we can go ahead and add it to the list. And if not, we can do that highlighting that we were talking about. And so if there is a contact, we're going to do something. And then if there's not, we're going to just copy that this.addContact to selected record list method and then add it inside of our else. There we go. And now we can look and focus on highlighting those contacts when they're already selected. So let's go ahead and create a method for that. We're going to call this method just highlight selected contact and then pass in our contact ID. And then there, we're going to go ahead and set up a constant for storing those selected contact elements that we're going to be modifying. And we're just going to say this.template.querySelectorAll. And then inside of that query selector, we're actually going to use some template literals to map out a query of the DOM and that data ID within our query selector. And to do that, we're just going to say square brackets data-selectedID and then equals. And then we're going to use our dollar sign to let us merge in a property there and curly brackets and then contact ID. And then what that does is give us that template string that will be generated when it's actually doing that query for us to then go and find all of those selected elements within our template. And we're going to take those and we're going to write a for each against them to iterate. And so we'll go selected contact elements dot for each. And then we're going to specify a single element and use an arrow function to pipe that into our curly brackets. And we're just going to say element.setAttribute. And the attribute we want to set is class. And that class we're going to update to slds-item. And then we're going to add in that class we wrote around adding the shadow to the element and just say selectedItem-shadow. Now, we don't necessarily want to forever highlight this contact. We only want to highlight it for a short period of time. So we're just going to add a little set timeout here. And then we're going to go ahead and then use an arrow function once again. And then once that timeout has occurred, we're going to go ahead and say element.setAttribute and then class. And then we're going to reset it back just to SLDSItem. And then once that's done, we're going to say we just want to give it 500 milliseconds. And then it will unhighlight the contact for us, just for a little catch so that we're not for clicking the contact and then it just being highlighted for a long period of time. And so now let's go ahead and add that into our if statement. I'm going to say this.highlightSelectedContact, pass in the contact ID, and then go ahead, save that, push it to the org, and we should be good to go and go and test this out. So let's go ahead and check out our results. As we select on the first contact, we can see it's added to the list. And as we select it again, you can see that instead of adding it to the list like it was earlier, it's validating that it isn't already there. And if it is already there, it's highlighting it to let us know that that change has occurred. And there you go. There are two more ways that we can use data attributes to really enhance our Lightning Web Component development. Thank you very much for checking out this quick take. Please like this video and subscribe to the Salesforce Developers YouTube channel. If you'd like to hear more from myself, you can follow me on Twitter at StephanWCG or catch me on email at Stephan.Garcia@Salesforce.com. Thank you very much and have a great rest of the day.